The topic is contour diagrams. So let's do this example. Sketch at least 4 labeled contours for f of xy equal x plus 2y squared. All right, so let's look at the definition. Definition says a contour at z equals c is the set of xy's such that f of xy is equal c. In other words, a contour at z equal c will be the set of all point xy's such that x plus 2y squared will be equal c. All right. So what do we mean with that? We know that x plus 2y squared is equal c. Using square root method means that x plus 2y is equal minus or plus square root of c. And these are two lines, right? It's a set of two lines. In other words, if I solve for y, this is going to be what? 2y is equal minus x plus or minus square root of c. And then divide by 2, you get y equal minus x. One line will be minus x over 2 or minus 1/2 x plus square root of c over 2, or y equal minus 1/2 x minus square root of c over 2. All right, at c, at the height c equal 0, y will be equal, if you plug a 0 for both, you get y equal negative 1 over 2x, because 0 over 2 is 0, or y equal negative 1 over 2x. So in this case, we got one line instead of a pair of lines. So c equals 0, c equals 0 will be this line. I mean, to graph this line, when x equals 0, y is 0. When x equals 1, plug the 1 in there, then you get negative 1/2. So negative 1/2 is right here. So it'll be this point, this line. So c equals 0, we get that line. Now I'm gonna use, instead of using c equal 1, I don't want to get square root of 1/2, trying to get integers, so I'm gonna plug c equal 4. It's a perfect square. So c equal 4, what do I get? Y equal negative 1/2 over x, square root of 4 is 2, 2 over 2 is 1, plus 1, or, and then use the other line, or y equal negative 1/2 x minus 2 over 2 is 1, so minus 1. So in this case, we're going to get two lines. To graph this one, y intercept is 1, and then x intercept, you know how to find x intercept, it's going to be 2, which is right here. It's going to be a parallel line, and of course it's going to be parallel because they have same slope, negative 1/2. So, which one did I do? Plus 1, yeah, that's, so c equals 4, I get this line, and to graph this one, y-intercept will be negative 1. And x-intercept will be 2 times, it will be negative 2. x equal negative 2. So this is still c equal 4. So if c equal at the height z equal 4, you'll get two lines. All right, what else? Let's do c equal 16. C equal 16, what do we have? Y equal negative 1/2 x plus 16 here. Square root of 16 is 4. 4 over 2 is 2. So plus 2. Same thing. Y equal negative 1/2 x minus 2. Right? I'm plugging it here. So in that case, y-intercept here is 2. X-intercept will be 4. So it's right there. Another way of thinking about this, we're just shifting this one unit up, or shifting it 2 units up. And this is shifting y equal negative 1/2 x 1 unit down, and this is shifting it 2 units down. So shifting it 2 units down will be just this one. So those are going to be c equal 16, c equal 16. By the way, you can notice c cannot be negative because it's inside the radical. So c has to be positive. So it has to be at least 0 or bigger. Or you can even see it here, something squared equals c. C has to be positive or equal to 0. So we got all these lines. So how do we describe the contours and how they're spaced? So the contour is the set. The contours are parallel lines, right? They have same slopes. They are parallel lines, and they are evenly spaced with slope. Let's put the slope with slope negative 1/2, and they are evenly spaced, right? It's the same distance between both, right? This distance is equal that, is equal that, is equal that, and so on. So in other words, they're not getting closer to each other, or they're not getting apart from each other. And that's it for this example.